Hello everyone, welcome to the next lecture on the testing of the hypothesis. Based on your several requests, now I create this next lecture on the hypothesis of the randomness called as the run test. So which is a basically a non-parametric test. Myself, Dr. Garg, working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute, India. You can contact me, either of my email IDs are there, or else you can simply follow this link for finding the more videos on the probability and statistics. So what we have discussed so far is that we have discussed the Z test, T test, F test, ANOVA and Kaiske test are there. And make sure that whenever, if you remember that when we try to solve all these testing of the hypothesis, there is a one fundamental assumption that whatever the sample you have taken, the samples, it may be the one sample or it may be the two sample, it may be the more than two samples. So if you taken as more than two sample, then we apply the ANOVA. If you apply that, if you take another two sample, we apply the two sample Z test, two sample T test and so on. But whatever the sample you have taken, there is a fundamental assumption that the sample you have taken from the population is of the random nature. But what is the authenticity of this randomness, of the sample taken as a randomness? It is not being verified so far is that. So it is desirable to verify this assumption that whether the assumption of the randomness of the sample is actually true or not. So that's the major purpose of this today's lecture, to verify whatever the assumption you have taken during the testing of the hypothesis is actually the true or not. In order to understand this testing of the hypothesis, this test of the significance called as the test of the randomness, that is to verify whether this sample you have taken is a random or not, we define the new test called as the run test. And it is based on the theory of the run. What is the theory of the run? We will see in here. So basically the purpose of this run test is to check whether the samples you have taken from the population is random or not. This run test is also called as the testing of the randomness, and it is also be with the help of the name Wold Wolfis. There is a two mathematicians here, which first one is born in 1902 and thus this one is the 1910. Now what is a run is there, because this run test is there. So first of all, what is a run? So you can see run is a sequence of the symbols. What is the symbols are this symbol? It may be the, like if you toss the coin, I can simply firstly explain you with the example. What is that? If you toss the coin, what will happen? It may be that you will get a head. If you toss the coin 10 times, what will happen? It may be that you will get the output as a head, tail, tail, again head, head, tail, head and so on. Okay, or it may be that you may get the output as like this way and so on. So the run is a sequence of the symbols. This is a sequence of the symbols of the first one kind. This is a one kind H surrounded by the sequence of this or symbol of the other kind. So you can see this is first kind surrounded by the second kind B. This is the one kind which is surrounded by the second kinds and so on. And the length, the number of the elements in this run is called as the length. We will see in a couple of the examples how we can identify that. So for example, say a data scientist carried out the research interview of the 10 different persons, and he has recorded the gender of the persons by the M for the males and the females. So how the person will came in the interviews? So there are so many choices are there. It may be that the first 5 are the men and then for the females. Second one is the firstly female, then men, female, men, then so on. And later on it may be that. So and many more are there. So it is one of these scenario are there. And you can see this is the sequence of the symbols. So symbols are men and so on. So on. How you can define the length of the, so you can see this is the sequence of the one category, that is a men. This is a sequence of the two, second category. So how many categories are there? Two. So we can see the length of this run is my two. In this case, this is a female, this is followed by the man, this is the first category, this is the second category, it is again surrounded by here, this is third category, this is a fourth category, this is a fifth, sixth, seventh, and all are these separate are there, so it's a 10 are there. Similarly, you can see this is the first one category, so I call as the one, this is the second, again this is the third, this is the fourth, this is the fifth, I call this run as a 5 here. So that is basically what is the run is, you can simply discretize this into the symbols are there. So symbols of the one category and followed by the second. Similarly, you can see the second example. Suppose the applicant for the post of the professors are given like here. You can see the male and females are there. So you can again see how many runs are there. This is one category male. This is the both category in the same one. Females are in the same two. This is a three. This is the four. This is a five. This is the six. This is the seven. This is the eight. And this is nine. So we can say these are the nine runs. Now, if you carefully look about these two examples, you can see some of the runs has the two small. These are two small runs are there. These are two large. These are some intermediate runs are there. And again, you can see there are the nines are there. So it means sometimes the run is a small, sometimes the run is large. So the question arises is when we consider as a run and when we will not consider as a run. So that's one of the most important thing is there. How you consider as a run, that I can explain you here. So if the similar items are clustered together, then you can't say that it's a run. What is the meaning of the cluster together? You can see here, this is the tail. All are the similar items which are clustered at the single place. Similarly for here, these are the similar items of the head, which are clustered at the same place. So whenever this kind of this situation happens, then you can't consider as a random. That is, the number of the proportions of the head and tails are same. In this example, it's the same. It may be that it will not be same like here. If this is not be there, then there are the five tails, four head. But the clustering is again the same. So in that case, the sequence cannot be considered as a random because there are only two runs. Because if you cluster them as there, then there are only the two runs. On the other hand, if the similar items are alternative mix, what is the meaning of the alternative is? The first one is a tail, then head, then tail, then head, and so on. So what is that? You can also call as this is a cyclic process, like say tail, head, tail, head, tail, head, tail, head, and so on. This is a cyclic process. So how many runs do you have in this case? Like here, this is a one, this is a two, this is a three, this is a four, this is a separate five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, and so on. So these are 10 runs are there. So the sequence, again, this sequence is not be considered as a cyclic because it has the cyclic process are there. So that is, this is not be there because there are the too many runs are there. So what is the meaning of that? If you consider, again, look at this example. So you can see these are the clustered together. So it means this is not the run. If you look at the second example, they are the cyclic. So it means it is not the run. If you look at the third example, it is not the cluster together, it is not the cyclic. So it means it has a run. Similarly, if you look about the second examples are there and so on. Now, once you will identify that which one of the run or not, then your target is to identify these symbols. N1, number of the symbols of the first kind. N2 is the number of the symbols of the second kind. So you can see this is not the run, so you can't calculate for here. Number of the symbols of the first kind. So I consider first kind is my male or the men. How many men's in this case? This is 1, 2, 3, 4. So N1 is my 4. What is the symbols? What is the N2 is? You can see the symbols of the second kind. So what is that? Number of the females are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So N2 is my female. It is called as the 6. And G is called as my number of the run. That is the length. So what is that? This is the first category, this is the second, this is the third, this is the fourth, this is the five. So G is my five. Similarly, if you look at this example, so you can see number of males, how many males are there? This is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. How many females are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How many runs are there? You can see this is a one. This is one category, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So once you are defining this sequence, then you are able to find this N1, N2, and G. But the question here is, sometimes it is not always given that in the form of the symbols. Like, what will happen if you obtain the marks obtained by the students? The marks obtained by the students are always in the form of the numbers. It can't be represented in terms of sequence or the symbols like H and T, men's and female. Then the question arises is, how you can find the value of n1, n2, and g, because n1 is the symbols of the first kind, but here is no symbol is of the first kind. So whenever there is a condition of like this way, then you have to firstly convert these numbers into the symbols. How you convert these numbers into the symbols? We will use the median value. That is, we firstly convert them into the symbolic form by using the median values, and hence define the run. Hence define the run means we will find the n1, n2, and g. How we can do that? You can simply see, say if xi's are your given observation, we will find the median values as we did in the normal manner, writing in the ascending or descending order. Then we will find the median and then replace the numbers with the symbol a if the observation is greater than of the median, if the symbol b if the observation is less than of the median, and we can ignore the number if the value is equality median, like here. So if you consider this one, you can arrange them how you can find the median of this, how you can find the value of the n1, n2, and g for this example. So we can firstly write in the ascending or descending order. So if you write them ascending, you can see here, you can easily find the median of this series. So this is nothing but my, it's a even numbers are there, you can see here. So the median is 50. So you can replace this symbol A if the marks is greater than 50. You can use the symbol B if the marks is less than 50. You can see this number is less than 50, so it is replaced as a B. This number is greater than 50, it's a A, and so on. So now you can see what is the N, N1. So number of the A, symbol A, how many A are there? This is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So A, N1 is my 5. N2, number of the B's, how many B are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What is the length of this is? You can identify the length is. You can see this is the first category, this is the second, this is the three, this is the four. Now they are same category. They are the five, they are the six, they are the seven. So G is my 7 R. So you can see the number of the runs are 7, number of the B's run, number of the A are. Now once you are defining this value of the N1, N2, and G, now we can see depending upon this value of the N1 and N2, we can identify that whether it's a small sample or the large sample. So whenever N1 and N2 both are less than of the 30, remember that it must be the both, then we consider as a small sample. We apply the testing of the randomness with the help of the three-step rule. Step one, define the hypothesis. Step two, we will compute the test statistics, and finally conclude the conclusion. How you define the hypothesis is, since our target in this run test is to check whether the sample taken is a random or not, so my H0 is always, this is always be that whatever the problem is there, the process that generate this is a random, and the alternative is not a random. And why we consider as a two tail? Because there are sometimes there are too few and the too many runs are there, which is the lack of the randomness, as we indicates that whenever there are the too few and the too many runs, we can't consider as a run. So therefore, it is always be appropriate to use the two tail test. So once you are defining the test of the hypothesis, then we will calculate the test statistics by N1, N2, and G. That is N1 as we discussed earlier. Once you are defining the N1, N2, and N3, we will conclude that whether it is accepted or rejected. Based on the value of the N1 and N2, you can find these critical values from this run table. You can find this run table from the any of the standard books are there, or else you can simply go to the Google. You can see this is the critical values of the run, and you can see that when N1 and N2 are less than the 20, these are the values are there. For example, if I say N1 is my 6, N2 is my say 3, and the level of significance is my 0.05. What is the value of the GL and GU? So 6 and 3. So you can see this is a 6 and this is a 3. You can see that two upper is a lower number, below one is a lower and upper. So that is a 2 and infinity are there. This is a 2, this is infinity is there. Similarly, if you want to find the numbers as say 6,5, you can find from here 6, and the 5 is my 2,10. So once you are finding this value are there, and you can compare the value of the G whether it lies in between them or outside them. So if lies in between, we will accepted the H0 or fail to rejected H0, otherwise we will reject the H0. So let's see, with the help of the 4 to 5 example, we will see how we can solve them. Say if you toss the coin 20 times and the following sequences are observed, you have to use the run test to check whether the coin is biased or not. What is the meaning of the coin is, sorry, coin is unbiased? It means the tail and head is equally likely. That's the meaning of this. So once it is equally likely, it means that will fall under your H0 and H1. Now, what is the H0 is? You are considering the sequence is my unbiased, and what is opposite of this is coin is biased. Can you consider this sequence as a run? Yes, because it is not with the cyclic and it is not with the cluster together. You can see H, T, it's not with cyclic, are there? So you can consider as here. This is a step one. What is the step number two is? We will try to calculate the N1, N2 and G. So we will taken from this sequence, and then we will see how many N1, that is the number of the heads. You can count them. How many heads are there? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So this is my here. You can count the tail also. How many tails are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You can also find the run. Like here, you can cluster them. This is the one group. This is the second group. This is the third group. 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th and 11th. So that this G is my 11. So therefore, the test statistics is my G. Now, how you conclude them? Now you can see the value of the N1 is less than 20. N2 is again the less than 20. So we consider this as the small sample. Once is a small sample, we draw this graph out there. Our target is to find the value of the GL, value of the GU at 5% level of significance with N1 is 12, N2 is my 8. So we can see N1 is 12, this is my 12, N2 is 8 here. So what is the value of this is 6,16. So therefore you can see your GL is my 6, GU is my 16. Also, you can taken as M12 from this side. You can taken 12 from this side, 8 from this side. So again, you can see the same values are obtained here. You can see this is the 12, this is the 8 is my 6,16. That's a similar value are there. Now it means this value is my 6, this is 16. So where this value lies that? This value lies in between them. So since it lies in between them, so we will fail to reject the H0, that is, we accepted H0. What is H0 is that? In this example, H0 is my, the coin is unbiased. So we conclude that the coin regarding is my unbiased. Look at the second example. So if on a computer train, the conductor wants to see whether the passenger enters in a random manner or not. So he noted down the sequences of the male and females and write down here. Again, you can see it is not with the cyclic. It is not with the cluster together. So it is considered as a run. What is your H0 is? So since our target is to consider as a random, so we can say the pattern of the sequence is of the persons is my random. Otherwise, it's a not is a here. Now you can define your N1, N2 and the G. What is the N1 is? Number of the females. You can consider as a females. It's accounting as a 15. How many males are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. How many runs are there? You can see this is the one run, this is the two, this is the 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 are here. So therefore, your test statistics is this. Again, you can see this number is less than 20 N1. This is again less than 20. So your is a small sample. Once a small sample, you can again find the value of the GL and GU. Now with the help of N1 is my 15. N2 is my 10. So you can again see on the table, this is a 15 and this is my 10. This is my 7,18. So 7,18 is my value of here. Now this is my 7, this is my 18. So what is the value of this lies that? Again, it lies in between them. So you can see we failed to reject it H0. It means we may accepted the H0. So and that is, we say the peoples are entering in the random manner. Look at the another example is, now you can see that the symbols are not be given. Here the numbers are there. So we will firstly convert them into the symbols. How you convert them? We will use the median. So that's a very simple again. So firstly, you can define the hypothesis. That's a random process here. So we can convert them into the median. So we will firstly try to find the median of this series. We can arrange them in the ascending order, and we can find the median as 27. So we will replace all those number with A if number, if observation is greater than 27, like here, this is not B. So this is, the second number is replaced by A, third is not be replaced, fourth is not be replaced, and so on. We will get these numbers are there. You can see this number is 27, but it's an equality, so we can left them here. Similarly, all those numbers which are less than of the 27, we can replace them as a B. You can see these two numbers are skip. Why? Because these are equality 27. So we can ignore the numbers when it's a median are there. Now it's a symbol. So once it's a symbol, you can compare the value of the N1 and N2 from here. So what is the N1 is 9. You can easily find that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How many runs are there? You can see this is the 1 run, this is the 2, this is the 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is a combined 1B because this is a continuous series. This is the continuous series. This is the 8, this is the 9. So my run is my 9 again. Now again you can see this is less than 20, this is again less than 20. So you can see it's a small sample. And again you can find the value as 5 and 15 are here. This is 5. This is 15, 9 again lies in between them. You can see we fail to reject it. But what will happen if at least one of the value is greater than 20? So then we will consider as a large sample. So whenever it's a large sample, we all know that it follow approximately the normal distribution. And if it is a normal distribution, then we will consider the mean and the variances as here. N1 and N2, we can already find that like here, where n is my n1 plus n2. Again, we will use the same technique. Step number 2 is same. We will calculate firstly this, and if at least one of them value is greater than 20, then we will compute the value of mean and variances like here. We will find the g as we find from here, and then if at least one of the values is greater than 20, we will find the value of the z with the help of here. And finally, we can conclude them based on the critical value of the Z test. All of us knows that 1.96 value at the 5% level of significance for the two tail and so on, like here. So if we consider the 48 toolbox for the machines, which are represent for the good and the defectives are there. Again, you can see it is not with the cyclic, not with the cluster together are there. So it is considered as a run. So we can define the H0 and H1 as a similar manner. The process generated is a random, otherwise it's not. We will firstly find the value of the N1, N2 and G. You can count the number of the G are here. You can count the N1, N2 and G. Now you can see N1 is my greater than 20, although N2 is less than 20. So since one of the number is greater than 20, so we consider this as my large number. So once it's a large sample, we will find the mu and sigma. We can use this formula where n is nothing but n1 plus n2, like here. So after substituting all these values are here, you will get these results. So therefore, the value of the test statistics is my z of this. So this number is my, after the calculation, you will get minus 2.61. Finally, step number 3 is the conclusion. Now since it's a large sample, so we know that at the 5% level of significance, what is the critical value is? 1.96. So this value is 1 minus 1 point, this is here. So minus 2.61 lies here. So what is the meaning of that? It lies in the rejected portion. So it means H0 is my rejected. So what is the H0? H0 is rejected. What is the meaning of that? We will accepted H1. It means the process which we have taken here is not with the random. So once it is not the random, it means you have to apply, if you want to apply the t-test, f-test is not be applicable for such problems are there. Look at the last examples are there. So if you consider the 30 tosses of the coin, falling sequences are there. Again, you can easily see that they are not clustered together and they are not be a cyclic. So it can consider as a run. So determine the number of the runs. It means you want to calculate the value of the g. You can see easily what is that. This is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. So G is my 22. Now you have to find the value of the N1 and N2 and check whether it's a greater than 20 or less than 20. And if it is greater than 20, we consider the large sample, otherwise we consider as a small sample. So you can try it yourself and let me know your answers in the comment box. What is the test of the significance, whether the sequence is a random, accepted or rejected, so that I may understand whether you are able to grasp this lecture efficient manner or not. I hope you can enjoy this session too. You can find this channel name for finding the updated videos of the probability and stat. You can share this video with your friends. Till then, best of luck students. Happy learning.